Hello. All right. I want to welcome you guys to our Him Zoom. If you can hear me, let's get a thumbs up so we know technology might be working for us today. Awesome. It's good to see all of you this afternoon. I almost said this morning. I'm used to us worshiping together on a Sunday, and I miss that, and I'm excited for that time again. But while we are social distancing, at least we have technology that we can sing some hymns together today. Let's open with a quick word of prayer, and we will sing songs together. You should, in the email that you got with the link for Zoom, have a PDF with the lyrics, the different verses of the songs we are singing. All right, let's pray. Jesus, we gather in your name today, thankful for all the ways in which you are working and moving, touching lives, even in a time such as this. As we sing praise to you, may you be lifted up. Thank you for the gifts that you have given us at Central Park, Ruth and Mary and Greg, Pastor Kevin, who lead us in worship and a word from you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
My Savior, am happy and blessed. watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Atonement for sin, and open the life gate that we may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. Great things he has taught us, great things he has done, and great our rejoicing through Jesus the Son. A purer and higher and greater will be our wonder, our gladness, when Jesus we see. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul.
It is well.
It is well
with my soul.
With my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, let this blessed assurance control, that Christ has regarded my helpless estate as his shed, his own blood for my soul.
It is well.
It is well.
With my soul.
With my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. And Lord, haste the day when my face shall be sight, the clouds be rolled back as a scroll,
trump shall resound, then the Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul.
It is well.
It is well
with my soul.
With my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
So it is well with my soul. It's a powerful song for us to sing together. Raises the question for me, a couple of questions. First of all, is it well with your soul as you're walking through this time? And how do we get to that place where it is well with our soul, regardless of what we're walking through or what's happening in life? Makes me think of a verse of scripture from Psalm 46, verse 10. And I think that verse provides us with some instruction on how to come to that place where we have that peace in the midst of whatever's happening in life, where God says in Psalm 46, be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Let's take just a moment and think about those words. First of all, be still. In this time, we have enforced upon us a need to be separate from one another, and we spend a lot more time sitting at home, probably being still more than what we would like to be. And so there's sort of this enforced upon us stillness, a setting aside of life and routines. But in this time, I would just encourage us to be intentional about being still as well. That if we want to be in a place where we experience the fullness of God's presence, and for our souls to be nourished, we need to be intentional about being still before God. It's easy in a time like this for us to push against the restraints that are there, the things that keep us from going out and doing things. But spend some time each day just being still before God. Maybe this is a good opportunity to try some new practices or different practices or something that you used to do. Find the time, make the time, take the time to be engaged in that practice of being still before God. Now, one of the things that came to mind for me a couple of Sundays ago, I read a quote from C.S. Lewis. And as I'd read a little bit more of stuff that he had written, it kind of gave me an interest in reading some more of his books. And I kind of looked through my shelf and I ran across the Chronicles of Narnia. Seven books, children's books, but they're stories, a made-up story of the land of Narnia, but it talks about that world being created and being redeemed and how to live the Christian life. C.S. Lewis weaves all those things into a children's story, and so I'm now on the fourth book of that series. I'm just reading it through in this time, and it's become a way for me to think again about what it is that God is doing. So be still before God. Find ways to come into his presence. That helps to make it well with our soul. So be still and know. And know. What is it? How do we know? What does it mean to know? We need to take and know from the Old Testament sense and not from a Greek, New Testament, or American sense. We so often think of knowing something as knowing it in our heads. So we have information about something. So we know that 2 times 2 is 4, and we know that the sun is a burning ball of gas, you know, millions of miles away. We know those facts. But when the psalmist says, be still and know that I'm God, he wants us to experience that God is God, to really experience in life the presence of God and the power of God and the strength of God that he talks about in the rest of the psalm. And so how do we move that knowledge from our head to our heart? How do we do more than just know about the power of God and to experience? Well, we experience it in the silence, of course, in the stillness. And then we also experience it just as we look at the ways in which God answers prayer and is present in life. And it happens not just in a time like this, but all in all of ordinary life that's led up to this. You know, I think about this morning about the story of this song, It Is Well With My Soul, being written. And you remember it's written by Horatio Spafford. He was an attorney and a real estate developer in Chicago, and in the 1870s, he lost a great deal of his fortune in the Chicago fire in 1871, and then his son died from scarlet fever, and of course his family was under a great deal of stress at that time, and so he thought it'd be good for all of them to take a vacation in England, and so he sent his wife and 4 daughters on ahead to England, and he was going to join them after he finished some business. And well, as they were crossing the Atlantic, there was a collision between their ship and another, and the ship that they were on, that the wife and four daughters were on, sank. And when his wife made it to England, she telegrammed back and said that she was saved alone. She alone had survived. And so he immediately got on another ship and went across the Atlantic Ocean to England. And when they came to that spot where that other ship, previous ship, had gone down, the ship's captain let him know. And it was there, over that spot, that he penned those first words of, "It is well with my soul." It says, "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul." He had learned in all experiences of life that God is present. And so even in the midst of the rolling sorrow of that time, to look for, to know that he could look for the presence and the power of God, he knew that God was there. And so even in the midst of the hurt and the pain, he could trust that it was there. And so the psalmist wants us to know, to experience that presence of God. So be still and know, finally, that I am God. Now notice the words at the beginning of the psalm that describe who God is. It says, God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. He is the one who is there when the waters are foaming and the mountains are surging. He is the one who makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow, shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. He is the one who is from everlasting to everlasting, present for his people. That he is a God who is God. And so in a time like this, when everything in our world seems to be upside down, and things seem to be out of control, they're out of our control, certainly, and no one seems to have the perfect answers for walking through this time, now we just need to remember that God is God. And that as we seek him, are silent before him, as we know him day by day, and as we trust him and know that he alone is God, we will find peace for our soul. And so that enables us to gather together and worship, just to sing the songs that are familiar, to remind our soul and our heart of what is true and of what we need to know. And so I love having a time like this where we can just sing songs that we can sing from the heart. And in all of this worshiping that we have done, you know, away from being able to be together, it's been hard. I miss, you know, even being in the sanctuary this afternoon and hearing the piano being played and songs being sung. It's a reminder of the loss that we have, but it also becomes just a reminder to sing together. And one of the things that I've done throughout these weeks as we worshiped online is that so often as a song is being played, whether it's a hymn coming, you know, with Ruth playing the organ or piano, or whether it's a worship song that Max and Alyssa are doing, I just close my eyes and I sing along. And no matter where I am, who might be listening, and with my eyes closed, I can see that I'm singing together with a whole multitude of people, and simply worshiping God. And so it becomes an opportunity to recognize that God is God, to keep on worshiping God and praising God and living in the strength and power that he provides. And so I trust that as we sing praise to God in these last few songs, that it would fill you with a sense of the knowledge that God alone is God, and that in the midst of the stillness, the limitations, the silence of life, that he is there, and that more and more we'll know who he is. And even more as we come through this time, we'll be able to say, you know, it's well with my soul. It is well with my soul. Let's pray together. Lord God, we thank you. We thank you for your presence, for your power, for your love. We thank you for all the ways in which you have just demonstrated that you alone are God, and we trust you. So would you receive the worship that we give to you in this day, that it comes from our hearts, and we thank you for an opportunity to just be still before you in this moment, to worship you, to praise you, to love you, and to experience the love that you give to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good afternoon, Greg, and I and Ruth are glad to be joining you on this hymn sing. The next song we're going to sing is "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Thou changest not thy compassion. Thank you. God's loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Let no one to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.